Hi friends, thanks so much for joining me today. I hope you all are having a wonderful day. We're getting close to the end of Emalyce. Kind of sad about that, but I don't think I can commit to uploading a video every day for life, so sorry. I'm excited to talk about some of the beauty resolutions that I'm hoping to commit to in 2021. So if that sounds interesting to you, stay tuned. By the way, if you're new here, hi, welcome. My name is Em. And you're watching Makeupry. If you're new here, please click that subscribe button and ring the notification bell so that you get alerted for every new upload and you can come back and hang out with yours truly. And that would be so fun. Plus, if you subscribe, you'll be eligible to win a little giveaway prize, which I will go into at the end of this video, so stay tuned for that. So let's get into it. I actually only have 5 beauty resolutions that I want to get through. I love my alfalfa hair. It's because my... Do you like my pebbles / alfalfa hair? Anyway, so there are really only 5 beauty resolutions that I feel as though I can commit to in 2021. And maybe these are things that you're interested in doing, or maybe not. Maybe you don't have any issues in beauty or whatever, that you're just like, this is entertaining. I don't know. I don't know. The first one's kind of a big one for me. And it is limiting my purchases to only 1 makeup purchase per month. I'm not going to just simply limit the amount of money I'm spending per month, because sometimes there are releases that are a little bit more pricey than others, and I don't want to completely exclude something just because of a price. However, I am notorious for going to Walmart, going to Target. I'm at the mall and all of a sudden I find myself in Sephora, or I wander by Ulta and all of a sudden I'm spending 50, 60 bucks per thing. And you know, I try out a lot of makeup, but I don't really try a lot of it here on YouTube. And I don't feel as though the products that I'm buying are really doing me any good. So I think it'll be best for me to limit the amount of purchases I make per month, so that way I am curating and being intentional about what I'm buying instead of just mindlessly buying something for the sake of buying something. So one purchase could be a few products in one order, or it could be a single store purchase. Obviously, I want to stay within a reasonable budget, and I tend to do that, but at the same time, I just need to curb my spending when it comes to makeup, because I am running out of storage. And yes, I can declutter, but I find that that's wasteful when I am spending so much money on products. I'm not getting full use out of them, which leads me into my second beauty resolution: commit to doing a project pan. Now, I did an empties and project pan video a couple months ago where I talked about a lot of the beauty items that I have. So that's, you know, body washes and lotions and hair products and skincare. I have a lot of skincare products. So I want to continue with that. And at some point, I actually do want to get through every single thing that's in one of my storage bins, which I'll go into in an upcoming video where I do an update on my project pan and beauty empties. So that'll kind of dive into which products that I think I can get through in 2021. But I also want to add on a second part. So if you've been around my channel for a while, you know that I like doing randomized makeup. I like going into my spreadsheet and then going into random.org and having it randomly select my makeup. I kind of want to do that with Project Pan, and I know I'm not the only one. I know I'm not the first one to do that, so I don't even know who to credit, but I'm not unique in how I want to approach it. It would be kind of fun to have a full list of every single makeup product I own and do a randomization of maybe 5 products that I need to attempt to use up or at least get a significant amount of use out of every month. So that could be a palette, it could be foundation, it could be a concealer, it could be an eyeliner, it could be a blush, it could be a highlighter, you name it. So I think that's how I'm going to approach it. So I'll do a monthly update on that as well, because I think it's important to get through the makeup that you already have before you buy a bunch of other products, and you don't really, you kind of just cycle through things, but you don't really get the full use out of them, and I find that to be such a waste of money. That leads into number three, which is actually using my makeup. I'm definitely not alone in this, and 2020 was a year where wearing makeup was pretty optional. And because of that, I have so much product that I still need to get through, and it's because I haven't been wearing makeup. And I love it, I enjoy it, I just am lazy. I have no excuse. There are ways to wear makeup with a mask on that isn't going to, you know, destroy your masks. I've done it. I just need to not be so lazy about it. So my intention is to wear makeup 3 to 5 days a week and starting to use more of my products up. For me, I just feel like I'm put together. You know, I just have some direction in the day when I have makeup on and I get dressed and I do my hair, and I feel complete. Even if I don't go anywhere, it's just the feeling of having done something for yourself. I feel like that's where I stand with makeup, and I just need to stop being lazy about it. Number four, this one pertains to YouTube. Now, I had intended to upload at least 3 videos a week on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, and it's been difficult to do that, especially with my school schedule and me just not feeling well enough to film, and just not having the space that I want to do that in. I'm in my office now. It is not complete, but you know what? It is what it is. But my goal, and I can't 100% commit to this because my schedule is about to change and I'm not yet sure what that looks like, but I am going to try my hardest to commit to uploading 3 days a week, Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays. Not only do I enjoy YouTube, but I think that with consistency, it will help my channel grow, which is something that I really want. I've been working kind of hard this last year to grow it, and you know, I've been on YouTube for over 10 years now, and I don't expect to be like a big YouTuber. It's just nice to see that the work that I put into the videos is being enjoyed by people. So that's kind of where I stand with that, is that with consistency, I feel as though my channel will have a better chance of growing a little bit more, you know? Anyway, number five, this one's a big one as well. For a while there, I was doing really well with cleaning my brushes every time I used them. I have my Parian Spirit where I can just do a quick cleaning of my brushes and call it good. Yeah, I've been lazy with that. I haven't done a deep clean of my brushes, nor have I done a quick clean of my brushes for a while. And I have a lot of makeup brushes, and I've gone through almost all of them, which is a sign that I need to wash my brushes, especially more frequently. Not only with my brushes, but putting my makeup away, wiping down my makeup station, and making sure all my makeup stays organized, because I find myself less likely to do my makeup when my space and my brushes and everything that I need to kind of center myself and actually feel like, oh, I'm doing something nice for myself. I need to not feel stressed out. I need to feel as though things are organized and clean and just easy to access. So that entails making sure my desk is clean, making sure all my makeup is put away and organized, making sure my brushes are clean. So every time I do my makeup, I will do those things. I will wash my brushes out when I'm done, which only takes a couple minutes to do. It's not like a deep clean. Honestly, it's the easiest thing ever. You know, and taking a quick wet wipe, wiping down my desk, and then putting away my makeup products. That only takes a minute, so there's no excuse for me not to do those things. So anyway, those are my 5 beauty resolutions for 2021. Let me know if any of these things are ones that you hope to commit to as well, or if there are other beauty-related resolutions that you're hoping to make or commit to. I would love to hear what you're planning to do or hoping to do. Well, talking about cleaning your brushes, it's time to announce what you could possibly win in this giveaway. Are you excited? There's 2 items here. The first one is a brush set. This one is from Real Techniques, and it's the All Eyes on You set. Super pretty. I love Real Techniques brushes. They're some of the best on the market. And then, I already mentioned this, you'll win a Parian Spirit brush cleaner. So how this works, you just take a towel, you spray it directly onto the towel, and then you wipe your brush against it. This especially works really well for larger brushes like foundation brushes, blush and highlight brushes, that sort of thing, because you don't really want to dip your large brushes into a well of cleaner because it can soak up into the ferrule and loosen that glue up. But if you use a spray, it is better for your brushes and you use less product that way. So I have been using Parian Spirit for years and years, and it's my hands down favorite. I have repurchased this time and again, and I'm excited to finally give some away. In order to win, all you need to do is subscribe to my channel if you're not already subscribed, and then leave a comment below just letting me know what your beauty resolutions are for the year. If you don't have any related to beauty, then just tell me what your hopes are for the year, something along those lines. You have until January 1st at 11:59 p.m. Pacific Standard Time to enter, and then I'll choose a winner after that. Oh, and if you can, please also leave your Instagram or your Twitter handle so that I can reach out to you if you win. Alrighty, that's it. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Please let me know what you think in the comments below, and I'll talk to you next time. Stay happy, stay healthy, and stay electric. Mwah. Bye.